I think you should make these kind of films more often, so it doesn't take another 10 years before you're back.
こういう作品をもっとたくさん作ってください。今度はロッテルダムに帰ってくる、戻ってくるのは10年待たないでください。
already before we saw your idea of heaven, I thought the hell was quite a fun place to be. There are, of course, we don't really know how hell looks like if it's there, but there are of course many depictions of hell around in history and art and things like that. So maybe you can explain us a little bit about your vision of hell.
この作品見たら地獄は割と楽しそうなところに見えるんですけど、もちろん美術のレクチャーを見たらいろんな地獄の絵とかあるんですけど、自分の地獄はどういう感じでしょうか。
僕にとっての地獄、こういう感じですね。まさにこれ、まさにこれですね。この映画を作ろうと思ったのは、自分が死んだ後、死ぬっていうことが映画を見た後なんか怖くなくなるといいなと思って、こんな地獄だったら行ってもいいかなっていうか、死んだらこういうところに行けるんだなって思って、もらえたらいいなと思ってこういう映画を作りました。
Well, my vision of hell is basically as you just saw it in the film, but, the idea, I got the idea for making this film because I started thinking at some point like what will happen after I die, and then I started visualizing that. I felt a little scared, and then I started visualizing the kind of hell that I would like to go if it existed, and that's the result of my imagination.
Yeah, that will be heaven, I guess. That will be heaven. I'm not a great expert on Japanese rock music, but I understood you're a musician yourself, so I suppose that helps when you make a movie like this.
日本のロック音楽は全然詳しくないけど、工藤監督も自分のミュージシャンで、それはこういう作品を作るのはもちろん役に立つんでしょうか。
これ作る。いやー、そうですね。割と僕はどっちかというとパンクが好きなんですけど、こういうハードロックとかヘビーメタル、今回はなんていうんだろう、テーマというかジャンルとしてはなんかそのキスとかブラックサバスとか ACDC とか歌詞にヘルってよく出てくるじゃないですか。でも日本人にとって地獄ってどっちかというと忌まわしいというか、悪いことすると落ちるっていう、とにかく辛い苦しいところだという考え方なんですけど、そういう西洋のヘルっていうのとなんかちょっとニュアンスが違うんですよね。その辺がちょっと面白いかなと思って、こういう仏教の地獄とロックのハードロックの地獄を合わせたんですけど、はい。
Well, basically I'm more of a punk fan myself.But of course, for this film, we took the theme of the hard rock, heavy metal as a genre. So if you watch bands like Kiss and Black Sabbath and AC/DC from those periods, they often use images of hell that sort of like are, you know, like exciting. Whereas, of course, in Japan, the image of hell that people have is more of a place, a scary place where you go when you do bad things, you drop.Into hell and all sorts of terrible things happen. So I thought I would like to make it's a sort of different nuance in the way you look at hell. So I tried to make a kind of a combination between that that image of hell that you get from hard rock bands and heavy metal bands and the feeling of hell that most people have.
One of the things I like about the movie and also gives its charm, I guess, is that we live in a time when everything fantasy is coming out of a computer in cinema. But in your case, it's almost like a theater play, or you have costumes, you have masks, you have all this kind of thing. So maybe you can tell us a little bit about the choice for this kind of, in fact, traditional craft in the movie.
この作品の一つのすごい大きい魅力のところっていうのは、まあ、今の時代は大体みんななんかCG 使ったりして、コンピューターからそういう映像的な、ものを作って、この作品はもっとなんか芝居みたいになんかコスチューム使ったり、マスク使ったりして、もっとなんか伝統的なやり方で、すごく魅力がある。
サンキュー。CG を使わなかったのは理由がいくつかあるんですけど、地獄っていうのはそもそも閉じ込められているという、意味合いもあるので、なるべくこう奥行きがないというか 広々してない方がいいなっていうのが最初のイメージだったのと、あと日本の子供たちが小さい時に地獄の絵本を読むんですね、みんな。で、こう悪いことすると地獄に落ちるよっていうのを教えるために絵本を読ますんですけど、その背景がこの映画の中の幕の燃えている絵がまさにそのものなんですね。なので、そういうなんかこう、子供の頃から刷り込まれている地獄っていうのを表現したかったのと、あともっと物理的にというか現実的に CG を使わないのでカメラがいくらでも動けるので、自由にカット割りをあんまり気にせずに作ることができました。まあ、CG 使ってないとはいえ、実はわからないようにものすごい高度には使ってるんですけど、はい、そういう意味では新鮮な感じになっていると思います。
Well, there are actually several reasons why we didn't use computer graphics or digital effects. First of all, I wanted to create this image of hell as a place where you're sort of closed in, a sort of claustrophobic environment, not too white. I didn't want to make it like too white as a space. So it's like a feel that you're really locked in into this space. A second reason is that in Japan, children from very small age are shown these picture books in which they see the visions of pictures of hell. So also that's why the reason also why in the background, as a background, we used where you see the burning flames. It's actually a curtain, a big piece of cloth that we had all around. Set to create that image of picture books that children used to see, like I did myself. And a third reason is more a technical reason. When you have a set like this, it's much easier for the camera to move freely. You don't have to worry about making cuts all that much. So in that sense, it gave us more freely. Of course, it's not true that we didn't use any computer graphics at all, but at least we got a much more natural sensation, a natural feel.
Thank you. I would like to give the audience a chance to ask a question. I heard you liked it. I mean, it's funny, so... Yes, please.
There's a lot of music, and it will be a welcome table for us here in Melbourne. This music ランドでも手に入れるCD とかになってますか？
今、ね、YouTube とか。今サントラ出ます。サウンドトラックは出ます。でも、こっちで売るかどうかはちょっとあれなんで、最終的に YouTube で。手に入らなかったら YouTube って言ってほしい。
Well, for the time being, you'll have to make do with YouTube. There will be a soundtrack. The soundtrack will come out, but I don't know if it will be available here in Holland. But if not, then please check YouTube. Kiss no fun.
Yes.
Why
本当はドラマとして映画に出ないんですか？あの彼も死んでるから。
そう、あの死んだ人、そういろいろいっぱい出て欲しかったんですけど、あのそうかっこいい人はみんな地獄にいるっていう設定なので死んだ人はみんな出したかったんですけど、本当に死んでる人はさすがに出れないので、ね、あのなのでこれでも。あの続編は作れると思います、そういう意味では。死んだ人はみんな出れるんで。
Actually, I did want to, I wanted to put more dead people in the film. Of course, they can't really be in the film if they're dead. But still, if think of it like this, I'm going to make a sequel to this film and then they're all be in there.
If
I have to say one of the two, it'll be Tarantino. Actually, you know, like the fat girl in the film is called Junko. That's a very common name in Japan, but we thought that sort of resembled Django. And actually, when I had these shots that I had a very, you know, like sudden zoom in, they called me, they called my Tarantino shots. Actually, we developed the idea for this film ourselves. I started talking to him, or we started talking to each other about we wanted to do, you know, like a rock comedy. So that was actually he was there right from the start of this project. And I'm a big fan of the movie Tenacious D with Jack Black. And I thought that sort of Jack Blackish way of overacting, you know, like going over the top. Nagase is the only one in Japan. Can do that. He's like my Japanese Jack Black.
We have room for one more burning question, and it's you.
How was it to work with the main cast?
To work with the makeup, you mean?
Yeah. The main cast. The actors.
Ah, okay. In general.
Yes.
All of them. Okay. ジュンコをやった、彼は、あ、
男なんですけど、僕と同い年でずっと一緒に20年ぐらいお芝居してるんですけど、舞台では女の子の役やったことあるんで、映画でやったのは初めてで、しかもヨーロッパの皆さんに受けるかなってちょっと不安だったんですけど、すごい受けたので安心して日本で公開できます。はい、神木くんも七瀬くんも、もちろん他の皆さんもミュージシャンの方も皆さん本当に素晴らしい役者さんでありミュージシャンだったので、やっててもうそれをとにかくその素晴らしいというか演技を取りこぼさないようにだけ気をつけました。
Well, it was great fun. To give one example, the Juko in the film The Fat Girl was of course played by a man. He's the same age, the actor is the same age as me, and we've been performing on stage as stage actors together for over 20 years, so I know him very well. And on stage he had done female roles before, but this was the first time he played a female role in the film. And I was a little worried whether the European audience as yours would actually get the point, or like, or be able to you know, find it funny. So I was very much relieved to hear your reactions to his performance during the film. So relieved, in fact, that I am now certain that we can also release the film in Japan. Oh yeah, and of course the other, the two main actors, Kamiki and Nagase, and the others who played the musicians, they all gave a fantastic performance, both musically and as actors. So it was really great fun to have them.